You got to believe in it. Anyways, we're going to go into our first match here. This is, again, Loser's Bracket action. We have the USA versus South Korea. Let's go.
Joey. He's been playing so well this weekend. Can he be the one to take out a Korean from this tournament?
Yeah, he's going to be the last non-Korean in the tournament.
Yeah. And we're on a Wallace stage as well.
Wallace stages are showing up more often than Walled stages. I feel like there's like 50 Wallace stages now.
I know.
Anyways, going to start it off here. And Chanel, again, using the formula here, going for everything. And one of the things that I really think shines with Chanel is the ability to sidestep and create opportunities for juggles.
Oh, yeah, for sure, because his movement is definitely his strong point.
Oh, yeah.
Sidestepping, backdashing, and creating those whiffs.
Oh, but whiff this!
Yeah, whiff that,
smell that death mist. Jeez, do it again. That was so... Oh, I can't believe he hit that.
Do it again. It's going to be dead. He's within kill range.
Oh yeah, definitely. And they're both close to rage as well. Once they have rage, Paul gets a really scary death fist.
He gets that blue boy.
Oh, I can't believe he went for ultimate tackle. The reversal going the other way. Puts him in rage. I think that's what he wanted.
Maybe.
I think that's what he wanted. Oh my god!
Big whiff on the back one, but no punish from Joey Fury.
Oh, I can't believe he hit that. He's going to have to be careful now. Oh,
catching that. And the key charge as well, lads.
This is the kind of match we're going to have. All right, Joey, let's go.
This is exactly what he did versus JDCR2. Let's see how Chanel responds.
Yeah, that's the thing. You know, when I saw him play against JDCR and I heard it was a 6-1 romping, I did not think it was going to be that, you know, confident. He was so confident in that matchup.
Yeah, okay, tackles him again. Nice break from Chanel, though. Nice duck and launch.
And it's looking really good for Joey right now. If he's able to continue this assault, it might be bad for Chanel.
And the chops to finish it, too. Ran straight. Chanel not looking so hot. He's still trying to play that poke play style, but Joey Fury with those down forward ones, putting an end to all of it. Picking his shots really well. Nice, tight shoelaces. Two throw broken. And we go, gets a float as well. Joey Fury, death miss, yes.
Nice, I'm getting the quarter circle forward three. The trooper roll, the follow up this time. Trying to check if he was going to sidestep, so I like the check there.
Yeah, he's definitely noticed that he's sidestepping quite a bit. Wants to stop him from doing that.
Ooh, oh my god, so scary. He went for a double throw there.
Every time you see a whiff and there's a pull on screen.
Yeah.
So scary.
If I hear Paul yell, it's gonna drive me crazy. I'm gonna throw my headset off.
There it is. One more hit could do it for Joey.
Oh no, the second hit of the flash elbow, able to land. And
oh gosh.
He is playing out of his mind. Three straight rounds against Chanel, are you kidding me?
Korean killer Joey?
Yeah, he is ready. And you know what? It's crazy because we didn't even get to see him use Paul against Nee. That might have worked. Who knows? He might have another chance if he's able to continue playing this way. He might be able to move even further in the tournament.
Absolutely. Yeah, we didn't. So can he take it? Now, Chanel has been in this position before this weekend. He has been a match down, but his ability to adapt is not to be overlooked.
Oh, yeah. Bar none, one of the best competitors in the world. Tekken. He's been so consistent these past years, especially since Tekken 7 hit the scene.
Yeah.
He's been able to place at close to the top almost every single time.
Yes, but however, Joey Fury with three rounds straight in that last match, what is Chanel going to do?
You saw him earlier when we interviewed him, he was talking about he's done his homework. And of course, I'm excited to see what he has planned. I mean, obviously the Paul pick, it's working out so far.
Yeah.
But this is the adjustment phase. Does Chanel have what it takes to be able to make a comeback here? Because it's a tall order right now. It's not looking good. It was three straight rounds.
It is, yeah. And Joey really seems to be getting into his mind as well, using those homing moves, really mixing it up with the pokes and the death fists as well. So let's see.
Oh, he gets a block this time. Goes for the low option. That's not guaranteed.
Yeah, look at that. Just chopping away, chopping away.
And that's what makes it scary, too. You don't want to duck against Paul. I mean, no one wants to duck and get hit by that big death fist.
Exactly. So it's just like free damage.
Okay, nice. Here we go.
A good side hook.
And because of its built-in nature out of the crouch dash, it makes it, you know, a little bit easier for tracking-wise.
Yeah.
So I'd like to see Chanel go for, like, a bit more riskier stuff.
Yeah, no duck on the 1-1 there, Joey. That could have done it for him.
Oh, my gosh, the back one whiff. And, you know, no one's been ducking that second hit of the down forward one string either.
Yeah.
He's been getting away with that quite a bit.
Tying the shoelaces. Big whiff. No launch, though.
Shredders into the chainsaws. That great stuff.
Oh, a little bit of a pop-up. Little shimmy.
Yeah, he didn't want a key charge, but he wanted to dance.
Right, so first round on the board for Chanel in this set. But Joey still, he had the life lead in that last round as well. Could have taken it.
Yeah, it was anybody's match. It just came down to the end scramble. Here we go. This is going to hurt big time. Oh, interesting.
Missed the death fist.
Yeah. He tried to pull it out really quickly there.
And he's got this wall pressure now. Chanel trying to size the battle there, but Joey not letting him out.
Yeah, not able to get the punish either. Joey taking notice of this, I'm sure.
Yeah. A lot of whiffs coming in from Chanel. Is Joey going to be able to capitalize?
Nice. Using the standing three, trying to create space. Going for the elbow. Uh-oh, here we go. Follow up.
Nice. Big chunks coming in here from Chanel. Joey's still with the life lead, though. 20 seconds left on the clock.
Nice, able to cancel, but stopping him in his tracks there with the down forward four. One of Elisa's fastest moves.
Yeah, Chanel is really waiting now, trying to be really patient, doesn't want to run into anything.
Yeah, less than 10 seconds left. Someone's going to have to make a commitment here. Down three, and now the life lead with Chanel. Oh, ooh, goes for the low cancel. Nothing in time, no!
That
where was the punish?
Punish?
Oh my gosh.
That was the right punish.
It was definitely the right punish. And Joey looking very confused there. Why didn't it hit? Maybe he did a bit too late.
Yes, and Chanel giving a lifeline there. Two rounds up now.
And man, we might be switching the position here. It might be three rounds straight for Chanel.
That is crazy. Look at this.
That's it.
Seven golden. Chanel evening up the set. 1-1.
Yeah, it's like it was not a sweat at all. He was like, you know what? I'm good, guys.
Apart from those first two, the last round, those first two were really in favor of Joey Fury.
Yeah, and he just made the comeback. He was able to clutch it out at the end. Yeah. And really, that's what matters, whether or not you win the round in the match. So here we go. It's going to be the final match between these two. Which stage is it going to be?
No wall.
All right, we'll see.
No
50-50.
Wall.
He's going to be sticking with Paul. We are at the stage select screen.
Yeah, he's been doing perfectly fine with Paul. So, oh, here we go. We've gone to the Akuma stage. I was wrong. Here we go. Last match, guys. Make some noise for Joey Fury and Chanel.
Oh, I can't wait to see the legendary fight in our winner's side after the. I mean, it's going to happen a little bit after this match.
The
but man,
Battle
I'm
of Gods.
Already getting ready. I'm getting hyped up for that one.
Got to get mentally prepared for that one. But now, 1-1. Joey Fury trying to take out the second Korean. He has a tendency of doing this, Joey.
Yeah, he likes
pre-release.
To build it up, right?
Yeah.
All right, here we go. He's going to lock in with Paul Phoenix. Tournament life rests for both of these players. Since this is the loser bracket, this next match is going to decide a lot of things later on in the event. Again, opening up with the lows.
Yeah, just poking away. He's been getting a lot of success with those small pokes, those court circuit forward threes.
It's just like that, you know, half of his life is already gone.
Yeah, and then catching Chanel whipping as well. Look at that.
Oh, he got the back one. He could have let it rip. That would have been it. But Chanel coming back now, doing extra damage because of the rage.
Yeah, switching sides as well with that throw. Really good stuff there from Chanel.
Oh my god, the whiff.
Where's the punish?
He was too scared. The active hitbox of the chainsaw maybe kind of deterred him from going in.
Yes.
Okay. Maybe he should have went for the power crush. I mean, it's one of the options that we probably haven't seen yet from Paul.
Paul having a really good power crush as well.
Yeah.
But yeah, here we go. Elisa with rage, trying to find his right opportunity. Joey not giving it to him.
What's he going to do? Oh, he caught him out of the air. That's going to be a death fist. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Joey Fury on the scoreboard here. Again, this is the last match between these two.
Okay, nice duck and 1-1.
Joey fighting back.
Joey really seems to be out poking and rushing down Chanel here.
Goes for the wall standing four. The knee. That's something I really haven't seen in the matchup so far. That knee very, very safe. And great to push at the end of the wall, but a great float there from Chanel.
Very nice. He should take that to the wall. Yes.
Oh, into the mid mix-up. Very, very good tracking on that move.
And a key charge as well. Maki's feeling himself. Here we go.
Tied up. Oh, what a whip, and I can't believe it hit. Where did that come from? The chainsaws, man.
He sidestepped.
Oh, he did it again.
Oh, my God.
And Chanel now feeling himself. He has him in rage, working on a perfect here.
Oh, seven golden. The momentum is on his side, and another key charge. He's feeling himself.
Chanel looking to eliminate Joey Fury here, the last hope for the Western world.
But great punish there from Joey. Big chunks. A great start to the round. Can Joey take it to the final round? I want to see it.
Again, going for the low. I feel like we're going to see that a lot, but here comes a low parry. The follow-up into the devil, man.
Oh,
what a unique getup. I can't believe it beat the option there. Chanel, great presence of mind, able to get out of that sticky situation.
Yeah, something specific to Elisa, but he still has the life lead here.
Okay, goes for it here. Goes for the mid option. Follow-up.
Hey, pokes.
Still chopping away, not afraid to do it.
One more hit could do it for Joey Fury. You just got to play patient.
Looking for that opportunity. He has to look for that opening. He's going to have to be very careful, though.
He went for it. Two throw.
Twist and shout. Follow up. Back two. Oh, my gosh. It's so much. So tense. 10 seconds left.
The slide.
Nice. Joey able to put the brakes on again. Oh, he gets it. The follow up. What's going to happen here?
Oh,
he got it. Oh, my gosh. He got it.